This is Mission Control Houston. The work week on orbit for the International Space Station's Expedition 30 crew began right after their Tuesday morning wake-up call. All of the crew members started the day taking either body mass measurements or calf volume measurements. That data that they gather in those measurements is for on-orbit, ongoing research into how a person's body responds to spending an extended period of time in the absence of gravity, as a person will have to do for the deep space exploration missions of the future. Each of the astronauts and cosmonauts on the crew also had one of their two physical workouts before lunch today. Those exercise sessions are designed to help the crew members combat the bone and muscle loss that comes as a result of a long-duration trip into space. A lot of time was spent on some power reconfigurations today, following a lab power router reconfiguration yesterday, along with a reordering of the command and control computers that was done to prepare for today's hardware reconfiguration. That took place behind a rack in the Destiny Laboratory. Commander Dan Burbank rotated the Melfi freezer rack and went to work removing a secondary power distribution assembly jumper. That power jumper was installed last year in order to permit Mission Control in Houston to maintain control of the station if a main bus switching unit on the station failed while the station was decrewed. Of course, the station was never decrewed, and the MBSU never failed. Now that they're have a full crew of six back on board, that jumper installation was no longer necessary. Of course, the work required the removal of power from that jumper, and that meant that Burbank's work was very closely coordinated with the Mission Control Center in Houston as they worked through a list of power downs ahead of that jumper removal and then to repower the systems once the on-orbit configuration was updated. On Tuesday morning, the three Russian crew members, flight engineers Anton Shkaplerov, Anatoly Ivanishin, and Oleg Kononenko, did another video shoot for a Russian educational science TV program. The crew members then spent their afternoon working on either Russian systems maintenance or unpacking items in the Progress supply ship that is due to be undocked from the International Space Station in 2 weeks. It will be loaded up with as much no longer needed material as is possible and will serve as a garbage ship to dispose of that material during its destructive entry into the atmosphere. Flight engineer Andre Kuipers spent part of the day taking part in a European Space Agency public affairs event. He had a conversation with the Netherlands Prime Minister, Mark van Rutte, as well as students at Delft University in the city of Delft. The Dutch astronaut also then set up hardware for the VO2 Max experiment. That's an experiment that will measure a crew member's aerobic capacity. The measurements might lead to changes in the exercise regimen for the crew members if their aerobic capacity is seen to have been diminished. Kuipers also joined flight engineer Don Pettit for more time spent in what's called handover for new crew members to familiarize themselves with the station. They also conducted the first of a series of periodic health exams, taking turns, one as the medical officer and as the other as the subject, and then reversing roles. Pettit also spent a part of his morning loading new software onto the Express Rack number 1 laptop computer, which is the computer that logs experiment data from experiments done at Express Rack 1. On Wednesday, the crew will continue to pack up the Progress vehicle. They will conduct the VO2 Max experiment runs. They also have plans for a lengthy annual maintenance task. They will be doing the yearly maintenance on the waste hygiene compartment, the American segment's toilet located in the Tranquility module.